survey after demonetization. Very hot topic, because everybody is aware that demonetization was one of the extraordinary situations like we are having right now. This present situation is very, very extraordinary situation. But of course, demonetization was only a financial extraordinary situation. In that topic, CA Bhupender Shah will deliberate, will teach us, will say that how the situations have arisen and how we have to cope with this situation. Sir, thank you very much. Please start your deliberations.
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening, sir.
I hope you are all at home and staying safe.
Yes, sir.
I really thank your VIPCA study circle for granting me this opportunity. Even during the period of crisis which we are facing, that learning must not stop. Learning is eternal and everyday perpetual. So let us start with the blessings of Devi Saraswati. Because without her blessings, nothing can be done. Of course, today's topic is that of money. That is her sister. But we have to thank Saraswati, which is the goddess of knowledge. Vakritunda Mahakaya Surya Koti Samaprabha Nirvignam Kurume Deva Sarva Karyeshu Sarvada. God only can save this globe from any difficulties which arise from time to time. Topic for the day is assessment, survey, search after demonetization, particularly with reference to section 68, 69, A, B, C, D, etc. November 8, 2016, 8 p.m. Our Prime Minister announced that currency note of ₹500 and 1000 is demolished with effect from 12 p.m. 8 November 2016. As you can see on the screen, two notes were demonetized. What is the real meaning of demonetization? Those two currency notes remain to become legal currency thereafter, and therefore 8 p.m., 12 p.m. on 8 November was the last time frame. It was just like a WTC of our own economy. You can see two towers, one of corruption, second of black money. Apart from these, there were several other reasons for demonetization. For example, terror money, drug money, etc. And these were tackled all at a time by demonetizing our two currency notes of 500 and 1000. The notes which remained in the hands of the people, what was the alternative? Samudri Karan, throw away. It was just like a India's Brexit, just as Britain has Brexit, we had Brexit. In this video, which you will not be able to see because there is no link to the video here, a person is throwing away notes. There was a lot of hype amongst the people. What to do with the currency which they are holding in their hand as on 8 p.m. 8 November 2016. Let me remind you that 9th November 2016 was a bank holiday. Why was it bank holiday? Two reasons. Firstly, transportation of new currency from RBI to the banks, and secondly, chance for the people to collect their currency notes and deposit in the banks as and when they deemed fit. Now let us see the background of demonetization. Before that, let us ask ourselves, was this the first demonetization? No, not at all. Earlier, there were two more demonetization. Number one, it was in 1949. Secondly, it was in 1978, when Janata Party came into power during the course of prime ministership of late Mr. Morarji Desai. So this was the third demonetization. But is this the last demonetization? No, nobody can predict whether this is last or not. Then let us see what happened thereafter. At this stage, let us understand difference between undisclosed money and money laundering. Undisclosed money need not be always money laundering. For example, suppose you and me, we have earned say 50,000 rupees, which we have not disclosed in our books of account. So that is merely undisclosed income and not money laundering by any stretch of imagination. If you see the definition under section 2 into bracket P of the PMLA Act 2002, which says, whosoever directly or indirectly attempts to indulge or knowingly assists or knowingly is a party or is actually involved in the process or activity connected with the proceeds of crime. Underline, proceeds of crime. So money laundering is always attached to proceeds of crime. Now, what are the proceeds of crime? For example, somebody has done murder and he has taken money and he is trying to introduce that money into his books. Somebody has done smuggling, which is a crime. Somebody has done trafficking in human beings, that is also a crime. Somebody has done business of drugs, that is also a crime. So proceeds of crime, whenever there is a case under PMLA, main distinction between money laundering and undisclosed income is that where there is no crime but only income is concealed, it is undisclosed income. But when money is earned with crime proceeds, it is money laundering. So we can conclude like this, that every money laundering is normally definitely undisclosed, because I have never seen anybody filing return of crime money. Nobody will file a return that I have murdered 5 persons and earned 5 crore rupees. But every undisclosed income need not be money laundering. Now, if you study further, then money laundering has been explained by the ICAI guidance note and various things, that it is generally from illegal means. Say, for example, selling of narcotics, drugs, extortion, arms, gambling, illicit liquor, etc. Now, first case of money laundering occurred in 2017, where one Mr. Rohit Tandon, he was found with demonetized currency recovered from him, and he was not granted the bail because he could not explain the source of that money which was in his possession. So demonetized currency, he was transporting demonetized currency on commission basis. So his bail was rejected, and rightly rejected by the Supreme Court, 87 taxman.com 260, Rohit Tandon versus ED. Now, another case though, which took place in the case of Nikesh Tarachand Shah, that also was immediately after demonetization, 87 taxman.com 257 Supreme Court. Here, section 45 into bracket 1 was held to be unconstitutional because there are two conditions for granting bail. The conditions are a public prosecutor must also be given an adequate opportunity of being heard for release of the accused on bail, and that was not granted under that section, and therefore that section was held to be ultra vires and therefore struck down. Now let us understand assessment, survey and search. Assessment can be of two types. One, without scrutiny, that is your CPC 143.1, or with scrutiny 143.3. Under section 143.3 also, there can be assessments of two types. 143.3, if you provide the details, scrutiny assessment can result into ex parte assessment. Under section 144, again with 143.3, if you do not provide requisite information to the assessing officer. Now, under 143.3, there may be further varieties. For example, suppose there is a search assessment, then it will be 153A or 153C, read with 143.3. There also, if you do not cooperate, it will be 153A or 153C, read with section 144. Now, having dealt with types of assessment, survey. Survey can take place under section 133A, and search, that is income tax raid, takes place under section 132. Basic difference between survey and search is that survey can take place only on your business premises unless and until your books of accounts are stored at residence only, then they can come to residence as well. On the other hand, search can take place anywhere, whether it is residence, whether it is house, whether it is office. Even when you are traveling, you can be searched on the spot. But survey cannot take place anywhere except the place of business. But search can take place any time of the day. Even you are traveling, you can be searched. At night, there can be search. And during daytime, there can be search. So having understood this basic framework of assessment, survey and search, now let us proceed with definition of section 115 BBE. Section 115 BBE was already in the statute book on the day of demonetization. Now, if you read money laundering but vis-a-vis section 115 BBE, what does it say? That certain unexplained amounts, for example, cash deposited in bank out of specified bank note, that is 500 and 1000 rupees currency note, which are deemed as income under either of group of six sections, 68, 69, 69A, 69B, 69C, 69D. Now, while applying these sections, AO does not consider whether the SSEs resorted to money laundering or not. So these principles must be kept in mind while dealing with the assessment, survey and such proceedings read with section 115 BBE. Because here there is no mention of money laundering, 115 BBE is automatically resorted to by the AO, and we will discuss in a few minutes from now and how that may not sustain in many of the cases. So section 115 BBE is a clear deviation from the objects of Money Laundering Act. Now let me categorically explain that demonetization cannot be construed in any way as extension of voluntary disclosure scheme. That at all, if at all that wrong notion is there in the mind, they should be removed, because Supreme Court had taken undertaking from the then Finance Minister after the VDIS 1997 scheme that such schemes lead to premium on dishonesty. For example, Vishwas Se Vivad Tak 2020, that also is not a disclosure scheme at all. That we will deal in few minutes from now. Now, let us see 115 BBE. What does it say? Based upon the reasoning, if AO is satisfied, so the discretion is with the AO, not with me, that is SSC. For example, some people wrongly understood during demonetization period, I will revise my return, I will offer my income under section 115 BBE under the head income from other sources. I have no source, but that is a wrong notion because the option is given only to the AO and not can be invoked by the SSE to show huge cash. At several seminars which I had physically attended, question was asked to me that why they cannot offer income of cash deposit under section 115 BBE by revising their old returns. You remember in 2017-18, there were 2 years time period left for filing belated return, and time for revising return was also left open. So that notion was created in the minds of several SSEs and even consultants that they put away this section which was prevailing at that time. So these news reached the finance ministry that there is a definitely some misuse of section 115 BBE likely to occur, and therefore it was necessary to issue an ordinance which will definitely amend section 115 BBE, and the same thing occurred. Now here you can see 115 BBE is not a disclosure scheme, as I told you. Now what happened? That section 115 BBE was amended. Now let us see the ingredients under which these are treated as income under section 115 BBE. First is a section 68. What is 68? Unexplained cash credit. Now let us remove our doubt. Unexplained cash credit can be in various forms. For example, cash deposit, check deposit, share capital, share premium, and unsecured loan, even sundry creditors for goods and services. In short, anything which occurs on the credit side of your balance sheet can be construed as unexplained cash credit. Now, what are the four requirements? Any sum, it can be 1 rupee to infinity, found credited. So in some cases, AOs have debited, AOs have added debit amount also, which is grossly wrong. Found credited in the books of an SSE. So that means there should be some books of the SSE. We will see whether there are no books, whether section 68 can be invoked or not. Second condition is SSE offers no explanation about the nature and source. Here your 115 BBE will come into play. You have simply deposited demonetized notes in the bank account without nature and source, then AO is definitely within his rights to invoke section 68 as per condition number 2. All explanation offered by you is not satisfactory. And fourth condition, that you have failed to prove identity, genuineness, and creditworthiness of the creditor. And what are the consequences? Consequences are that any sum found credited in the books of the year. For example, I have deposited old notes in the assessment year 17-18. That cannot be added in the assessment year 18-19 or 16-17. During the year, so we will summarize, sum found credited in the books during the year with explanation or with inadequate explanation, without proper identity, genuineness, and creditworthiness, then AO can add that under section 68. Now next is now how to rebut. You must have seen in several cases the AOs have added even sales shown by the assessees during demonetization period is unexplained cash credit of the assessee. This is wrong because first condition is that onus of proof lies upon the assessee. Agreed. But once you proved I had an opening stock, I had purchases for the stock, I sold the goods by selling those items in cash, and those items were below rupees 2 lakhs. And below rupees 2 lakhs, PAN number was not required at that time. So, can AO add that sales proceeds is unexplained cash credit? Answer is flatly no. Now, first requirement to fight out such cases is that AO must conduct proper inquiries. Your understanding should be clear at this juncture. Meaning by, once I have given the details, my onus is like a pendulum. It shifts from the assessee to assessing officer. Now, it is AO's duty to conduct proper inquiries before making any addition. In the case of sales addition, cash deposit addition, no inquiry is made whatsoever. What they have written? I find that there is a jump in the sales. I find that there is no corresponding sales in the previous year or the subsequent year or subsequent period. It is not the criteria. They have not made any inquiries whatsoever. So now the ruling case law is Kamal Motors 131 Taxman 155 Rajasthan High Court and United Commercial and Industrial Company 187 ITR 596 and most important is LIC of India 219 ITR 410 Supreme Court. ITOs have made additions merely on the basis of conjecture and surmises. Presumption, however strong, cannot become the basis of assessment. That is the settled law. And therefore, all the additions made without conducting any inquiries by the AO are likely to be deleted at appellate stages, whether it is in CIT appeal or ITAT or High Court thereafter. Now, let us see that the third condition, the explanation is not satisfactory. That is not disproved by the AO. Therefore, the inquiry is necessary. Now, second condition is, I am not supposed to explain source of the source. I know that there is an amendment under section 68, but amendment is only to the extent of share capital and share premium, that too only in the case of unlisted companies. So loans, gift, sale, etc. are not covered even as on today. So addition of sales made by the AO out of the demonetized notes is not correct because I am not liable to explain source of the source. Now I will give you an example. So many jewelers have shown crores of rupees sales on 8th November itself. You are aware that gold rate went up to rupees 55,000 rupees for 10 gram. AOs have stated that how is it possible to make so much sale in this 3 or 4 hours time from 8:30 p.m. to 12 p.m. on 8th November? Answer is very clear. I have delivered the goods, I have received the cash. It is not necessary that I should prepare the sales memo on the spot. Sale of Goods Act does not require that sale memo should be prepared on the spot. I can prepare sale memo later on also. So many AOs have made a remark that it is improbable that so many sales memo in the same handwriting could have been prepared by the SSC in 3 hours. But this presumption is wrong. And source of source in the case of sales even need not be proved by me. Rohini Builders 256 IDR 360 Gujarat High Court. In this case, even SLP is dismissed by the Supreme Court. So this is the best case available to us. And second one is Nemichand Kothari 264 IDR 254 Guwahati High Court. There also same principle is held. A source of source need not be proved by me. Now let us visualize the various possibilities. I am maintaining books of account, I am not maintaining. For example, I am a salaried person, retired person, 44 AD. Now let us see all the possibilities one by one. Suppose when I am maintaining books of account, there is a sufficient cash on hand. It can be out of my past savings, it can be out of past withdrawals, it can be out of sales, but that source is explained by me. It is upon the AO to disprove my nature and source. He cannot straightway say that your sales are bogus. So far, we have been fighting several cases of bogus purchases. Now, suddenly, we are on the other side and we are required to prove that sales are genuine. For that, we will have several cases in the next foregoing slides. One ITO cannot say the goods are sold after November for cash. But there is a word of caution here that after 8th November, you could not make sale of goods or services in cash in old currency because that was illegal. Now, books of accounts are maintained and you have sufficient cash on hand, then there is no difficulty and department cannot straightway reject. Now, difficulty will arise when books of accounts are not maintained or not liable to be maintained. For example, salaried person, retired person, 44 AD. Under 44 AD, there is a misconception of several assessors. They cannot say that each and every sale made by him was in cash and was deposited in the bank out of old currency. Sales must be adequate enough to justify cash deposit. And not only that, if you are declared only 8% net profit, then what happened to other 92% of the sales which are deposited into the bank? There you will have a difficulty. That means that if you have deposited cash which is more than the net profit, then you are likely to have queries from the assessment side that you please explain the source of remaining cash deposited by you. Similarly, in case of the person say having only interest income, rent income, capital gain and no business income, they are not liable to maintain books of account. Whether 68 is applicable or not, let us see. Now, impact of demonetization. Now, SSC produced this case law is very, very important from point of view of appeals. Sir, SSC produced details of all the withdrawals for past 7 years and claimed that he has deposited out 7 years, mind you well, not 7 months, out of demonetization money, and that was his saving. Then AO added that it was not possible for him to keep the cash on hand for 7 years. This was annulled in the favor of SSC, and the case is Shri Nirkanth Narayan 20 IDR 8 Supreme Court 19. This is pertaining to first demonetization. This will help you a lot. Now, books of accounts are not maintained. Although Section 68 strictly says that books of accounts are necessary for the purpose of Section 68, because any sum found credited in the books of account, that is the ruling line. But that does not mean that you are not supposed to explain the nature and source. You are definitely liable to explain the nature and source. Then AO can use Section 69A or 69B as the case may be. So that Govind Rajamula Mudaliar 34 IDR 807 Supreme Court.
Sir, couple of people have got some questions. Would you like to take them now or later?
Later, in the end.
Okay, sir. Okay. So, just for the benefit of the attendees, please keep typing in your question in the chat box and we will take it at the end in the last 15 minutes. Carry on, sir, please.
Yes, okay. I think there is some technical glitch here. Mr. Roonghta, can you see? Slides are not moving.
Sir, I can see your cursor and I can also see it blinking on CAN. Sir, why don't you try moving to the next slide?
No, it is not moving.
Okay, sir. Sir, I think you are using PDF, sir, right?
Right.
So why don't you try minimize it once?
Just 1 minute.
Yes, sir.
There is some technical glitch. Yes, I got it. Okay, fine. Are you getting? Hello, is it there?
Sir, so far we can see only your video.
No, are you seeing this slide?
No, sir.
No.
So can you click on start sharing again once more?
Just 1 minute. Can you see this now?
Not yet, sir. Rajesh, are you able to see it?
I can see his face only.
Yes. So
not the screen.
Now I can see the screen. Sir, now I can
see. Yes, now the screen has come now.
Yes. But slides have come?
No, sir. We can see your wallpaper. Oh. Beautiful wallpaper, sir.
Oh, and... technical glitches occurred suddenly.
Yes, sir. can happen, sir.
Anyway, I'll just continue reading from my slides.
Yes, sir. Go ahead, sir. Yes, sir. This is fine. We can see your screen, sir. Now.
Can you see this now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, it is.
Slides have come.
Yes, sir.
Slides have come.
Yes, sir. Slide. Yes, you are, sir. On slide 32, sir. We are, and yes, now.
Okay, can you see this?
I can see. Yes, sir. Yes, we can, yes, see.
Slide. Okay, very good. We'll continue. Sorry for, yes, interruption.
No problem.
Nature and source. I told you about nature and source. That you have to explain the nature and source. So, in the case of KK Hanif Khan 50 ITR 1, Supreme Court said, then where the prima facie inference on the fact is that the SSC's explanation is probable, the onus will shift to the revenue. This is very important for you to find in all your cases. Now, what is the tax liability? Under section 115 BBE, before amendment, it was 68 and 69A at the rate of 30%. But now, when there was an amendment, and it will make it 60% plus surcharge at the rate of 25%, so 75%. Now let us continue with our previous slide which you missed. Passbook is not a books of account. That is what Bhaichand Bhai Gandhi, 141 IPR 67 Bombay High Court said, and also upheld in the case of Man Singh Pitkar and Madhu Raitani, Gauvati third member. Department is quoting another case law, Sudhir Kumar Sharma, HUF, 239 Taxman, 264 Supreme Court. But mind you well, here only SLP is dismissed. So mere dismissal of SLP is not the law of the land. And secondly, if you can see, there was failure to give any explanation. Here, there is no failure to give any explanation. So, Bhaichand Bhai Gandhi's case still remains valid. Thereafter, can you see the slides? Hello? Can you see the slides?
Yes, sir, we can see it. Carry on, please.
You can see now. Okay. Now, another judgment came from Arun Kumar Muchhala, Bombay High Court. But here also, they have not distinguished Bhaichand by Gandhi's case. They have stated that failure to produce the decor, he did not give you a non-confirmation of cash. So then in that case, of course, there was ample scope for the AO to add the addition and confirm by the High Court. So in nutshell, the addition under Section 68 cannot be made if books of accounts are not liable to be maintained. Now Section 69, it is about investment which are not recorded in the books. Suppose your Kisan Vikas Patra is found, which is not recorded, and no explanation is given. But on FD or Kisan Vikas Patra, there is a date of investment that can be added only in that year, not in other years. Remember well. Similarly, Section 69A. Here we will take 1 minute more. Money, bullion, or jewelry, say demonetized currency. AO says you have not explained properly. So I will add this under Section 69A. But this is wrong. We will see in subsequent slides. Now, suppose you are found with old currency after the demonetization. What is the implication? There is a case on this direct case law, Andhra Pradesh Yarn Combines. This is quoted in several cases which you are going to discuss. It is a scrap paper. It is a junk. Illegal currency has no value. Suppose today you are found with that. You may be covered under money laundering, but Section 69A cannot be invoked because illegal currency is now a scrap paper and it cannot be under Section 69A. Now 69B, he is found to be the owner of bullion, jewelry, etc., which is under recorded. Section 69C speaks about unexplained expenditure. For example, expenditure can be personal, it can be business. Under business, it can be capital or it can be revenue. Under, it can be deferred expenditure also. All these expenditure which are record, not recorded in the books of account, and no explanation is given or inadequate explanation is given. Now, for example, certain purchase bills are found to be bogus. Then if you have offered this income under Section 69C, this will not be again allowed as a deduction under any other head. Earlier, what people were doing, that I have incurred 5 crore rupees expenditure on construction of this property. And again, they were claiming the same under the head depreciation or expenditure or whatever. Now, let us see, because you are all auditors. There was an amendment under the Companies Act 2013 also. And there was a specific requirement in the audit report where the company had provided requisite disclosure in the financial statement as to holdings as well as dealings in the SBN from 8th November to 30th December. In one of the cases I encountered, auditor did not give this B portion in the audit report. And AO says, I will reject your books of account because your auditor himself has not checked your specified banknotes availability or deposit. Let us see whether this will be valid or not. The answer is no. Audit report may be defective, but that does not make my sales or opening balance or other things invalid so far as my cash on hand is concerned. You may recollect that even in IPR, there was requirement that 2 lakh rupees or more cash deposited in specified bank notes, that is 500 and 1000, must be reported in IPR. And third requirement was that if at all you have online query from the CPC, then you have to reply online. Many people have made a mistake. In online query, they have replied, this is out of saving. And suddenly at the time of filing the return, they have stated, this is out of sales. So these discrepancies are really very serious. Now, below 2 lakh rupees, Rule 114E did not require you to report PAN number if the amount of cash sales was less than rupees 2 lakhs. So jewelers cases, this will help you. Now amendment which came to 115 BBE, that time late Mr. Arun Jaitley had passed the second amendment bill on 26th November 2016. Remember, demonetization took place on 8th November and amendment has come on 26th November 2016 and with effect from 1st April 2016. This is very much dangerous. Suppose there is a survey on your client's places between 1st April and 8th November. He has declared some amount and paid the taxes also at 30%. Now AO says, no, I will apply amended 115 BBE from 1st April and levy the taxes at higher rate. Whether this is valid or not, we will see in the next slides. So 115 BBE became 60% from 30%, surcharge 25% and says 3 to 4% is the case maybe. So 75% became the effective rate. And if you count 234 ABC, the demand of the demonetization assessment went up to more than 100%. So do you think anybody would come forward under Vishwas, Vibad to Vishwas scheme 2020 in the cases of demonetization cases? Answer is no, because you are liable to pay minimum 75%, which anybody can ill afford. Now, it is applicable for whole financial year. So let us see the ruling case law, Vatika Township, Supreme Court, 367 ITR 466. Supreme Court has categorically held that any amendment which is retrospective cannot be detrimental to the rights of the assessee. How can I come to know that my 1st April to 8th November, I have to pay 75%? Impossible. But any amendment which is beneficial can be construed as a clarificatory and therefore retrospective. For example, Section 40A1A. Various amendments took place that before filing or due date of return, opposite person is paid or not, etc., etc., etc. That can be clarificatory and that can be construed as retrospective. But this amendment to 115 BBE is likely to be struck down as not retrospective, as we will see in next slides. Now, Government of India had given assurance that normal person can have, say, businessman, housewife, artist, labor, can have a savings of ₹2,50,000, because there is a basic threshold limit of taxation. So people started depositing ₹2,50,000 in Jan Dhan saving, all savings account, housewife, even third party and what not. Those cases luckily escaped. But another offshoot of this was people started depositing in the account of tribal zone people, that is 10 into bracket 26. Their income is totally exempt under Section 1026. When the flights were going from particular portion of the country to, say, Arunachal Pradesh, Meghalaya, etc., when tribal zone are staying, there were flights of cash with full of cash, 500 rupees and 1000. This came to the notice of the then finance minister and he imposed a condition that thereafter any flight, charter flight going with cash will be checked by a person of the cadre not lower than magistrate. Now, what is the basic difference between old 115 BBE and new 115 BBE? Earlier, set-off of losses was allowed. Now it is not allowed. And it is with effect from assessment of 17-18, that is demonetization period. No expenditure will be allowed and no other deduction will be allowed. For example, you cannot say, I have earned this under Section 10A-10B, 80I-80B, etc., etc. Now, impact of demonetization. Where the assessee not having satisfactorily proved the source and nature of amount which he encashed on demonetization, AO was perfectly justified. These three cases, and one is of Calcutta High Court, 84 ITR 307 Calcutta, Anil Kumar Singh. If you give no explanation, then of course the AO can help. Now let us look at our favorable cases. Mehta Parikhen Company. No addition can be sustained based on pure surmises, because department cannot say that it was not possible after a particular date that the multiple of rupees 1000. Similar was in the judgment of 37 ITR 288 Supreme Court. When amount encashed on demonetization was a part of cash balance, I have an opening balance on 8th November. ITO cannot disbelieve out of just surmises. Lal Chand Bhagat Ambika, 37 ITR 288 Supreme Court. Now, similar case law, Gauri Prasad Haridas. When there are two possibilities, that my cash balance, do you think that in my cash book, I am supposed to write what is the denomination of the cash balance? No. Then cash balance, whether it comprises of 100 rupees, 500 or 1000, that cannot be questioned by the AO on the basis of surmises. So 47 ITR 634 Allahabad High Court is also very much useful to your assessment. Now Kanpur Steel, this is very, very important. High denomination currency notes could be stored more easily. For example, I am traveling, I will carry high denomination only. Why I will carry 1 rupee, 5 rupees, 10 rupees, 100 rupees? So it is not an unreasonable explanation. This has been followed in several cases recently decided on demonetization. So please bear in mind, most important case law, Kanpur Steel Company Limited, 32 ITR 56 Allahabad High Court. This is under old demonetization. Now, Lakshmi Chand Baijanath Supreme Court, 35 ITR 416 is also very important. Jeweler has made the sale of jewelry. So it is his business income. It cannot be converted into income from other sources only on the basis of presumption and surmises. It is upon the revenue to prove that how I have earned otherwise than by selling the stock. Now, not only that, there is one more penalty under section 271AAC, and that is also 10% of that provisions applicable there. Now, that means my effective tax rate is 83.25%. 83.25%, that is 60% tax, surcharge 15%, and sales, etc. So it comes to 83.10%. And penalty 10%, so 83.25%, 234 ABC separate. Now let us understand. 2,50,000 was the basic limit for the normal human beings, and senior citizen 3 lakh and super senior 5 lakh. So people thought that this is some type of quota that I have to fill up. They started filling up the income by other sources. So now that game is caught. So that Lily Tobias 266 ITR 401 Patna High Court. Now, a question may arise in your mind that whether such a retrospective amendment is constitutional or not. We just now read the judgment of Vatika Township, but now most important is this JK Synthetic 119 CTR 222 Supreme Court. Why it is most important? Because it is five judges bench. Firstly, what is the law of priority? Commissioner appeal is bound by ITAT, ITAT is bound by High Court is bound by Supreme Court is bound by Division Bench, Division is bound by Constitutional Bench, five judge benches. So if you quote this 119 CTR 222 Supreme Court, it is more than enough for you that any amendment which is retrospective is not binding on the assessee. Same judgments are there in the case of Nabard also and Pyarelal Sharma also, Hitendra Thakur also, that any statute which is retrospective cannot be detrimental to me. Now let us understand. 115 BBE, it is arbitrary, retrospective, there is no rational, and there is discretion which can be misused. Now, practical question. Let us take practical question. there are some assessment in which AOIS held that why you have deposited demonetized currency on various dates. That means you are not having the actual cash and you have deposited out of borrowings. The answer is very clear. Cash deposited on different dates cannot be added by the AO, no adverse inference, which is the ruling case law. Narendra Goradia, 234 IDR 571, Bombay High Court. Very, very important. First case, Narendra Goradia, 234 IDR, Bombay High Court. Now, let us see impact of 115 BBE. 115 BBE does not speak about old notes alone. It can be notes or any other asset. It applies to crime money also. It applies to all the SSEs, whether individual, HUA, BOI, AOP, trust, company. Let us pause here for a moment. So many cooperative credit societies made a blunder. They are not banks. Still, they accepted demonetized currency after 9th November 2016. And all the assessments they have held that you are not a bank and not authorized to accept old notes. And therefore, this is under 69A, dealt with 115 BBE. It also applies to resident and non-resident. It also applies to SSEs under 44AD and 44ADA and 44AU. And it applies also to black money, also cannot be declared. Now, therefore, this amendment, which is retrospective, cannot be held as a good amendment. Now, section 68. Let us come to the practical part. Now, it says that nature and source. Now, there is no guideline available. For example, my cash shell is there on the counter. Say, Big Bazaar, D-Mart, and all such big stores. Do they have KYC? No. How can you refuse that there was no cash shell? Therefore, such presumptions will be struck down in appeal. And more so because there are no guidelines available for Section 68, nature and source. Even sales is covered. Let us be fair. Sale is also covered under Section 68. But any sum cannot be construed by overlooking all my stock, cash shares, etc. and delivery. But there may be difficulty in proving cash shares, but that has to be rebutted by amounts below 2 lakhs, availability of stock, delivery of goods, receipt of old notes, and stock book maintenance. Now under 44AD, this we have discussed that many people are under wrong notion that 44AD does not require at all any such thing. This is not a correct notion. Therefore, they are also covered. Now, sale 115 BBE has no sunset clause. Even as on today, 115 BBE is still in the statute book. So once, say for example, shared capital is added, minimum 75% tax is there. Now, several surveys took place on cooperative credit society. They were not filing return under the wrong presumption that their income is exempt. No, their income is not exempt. They are eligible for deduction under Section 80P. So, for claiming deduction under Section 80P, you have to file the return in time under Section 80AC. They were liable to tax audit. They were not getting the books audited. There were no KYC. There were no PAN number available. Large cash deposits were there. They were using even cash checkbooks also, and large volume of cash advances were there. So what happened? AOS have invoked even Section 269SS and 269T in the case of cooperative credit society, because they are not banks. They could not accept more than 20,000 in cash or repay in cash because they are eligible for 80P, but they are not banks. And several other bylaws were violated by them. Now, let us come to the several decided cases which will help you in your assessments and appeals. First is that of M.D. Narayan Das, 67 ITR 368. In this last line, it is held that again, see here, Kanpur Steel Company, they have relied upon Kanpur Steel Company here also. And Kanpur Steel Company, as I told you earlier, that 28 high denomination notes could form part of the SSC's cash balance, and therefore the same could not be added only on the basis of surmises and presumption. So these are Allahabad High Court are all similar, and similar is that of Naresh Kumar Tulsian, 11 ITD 537. That also is on the same line. Department is always quoting Sri Lanka Energy case, but that can be used in both the ways. If you have not explained, that will go against you. But if you have explained, then AO should make the proper inquiries. Now, let us come to these cases which are very important. First one, Calcutta High Court, 84 ITR 307, Anil Kumar Singh, I told you, receipt of money by way of encashment of hard denomination note, the burden to prove the source of money is solely on the SSC. But once I have given the explanation, it cannot be rejected without any rebuttal by the AO. Coming to know of this type of manipulations by the taxpayer, the department issued one instruction to all the chief commissioners and principal chief commissioners on November 24, 2017, in which it was stated that what people have done, they have reduced the stock and shown the cash balance out of that by revising the return which were pending. So wherever the returns are revised without any proper documentation, they are added in their hands. They have shown higher sales. They have shown higher cash on hand as on 31/3/15 and 16 and filed the revised return. They have shown loans, advances, gift, repayment, sale of assets and generated cash. And they have also used several other techniques which were generating cash. But here there is a catch. Department has compared your VAT audit report, excise audit report with the tax audit report. Many people did not revise the tax audit report when the sales were increased. And tax audit report earlier filed was not telling with the revised return. So here there was a catch. Similarly, the assessees who incurred expenses in cash removed those expenses and created fictitious sundry creditors to create more cash on hand. Some people also resorted to show more cash sales and suppress the credit sales. All these techniques were forming part of instruction to the AO. So last, you can see 8 number. And they were guided to use 115BB in such cases. Many people also file well tax returns and they have shown a lot of cash on hand, gold, etc., out of which they have converted into cash in hand. And therefore, the CBDT has told that these are mere guidelines and AO is free to use his discretion to look into the matter and make the addition wherever necessary. Now, let us see some of the recent judgments. Mr. Rungta, how much time you have got now? Hello? Hello? How much time we are left with?
15 minutes, sir. Please
okay,
go ahead.
Okay, fine. I'll cover up in 15 minutes and question answer, okay?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. First judgment has come from Jaipur Tribunal in the case of Satish Kumar Agarwal on 115 BBE. That it is not retrospective. You can see they apply to 16-17 also, where excess stock by invoking 115 BBE, which is held not retrospective. Same is also followed in another case of my client, in the case of Gyandeep Kemka, again from Jaipur Tribunal. Now, recent trends. These are very, very important. Please bear with me for a few minutes. Exxon Global Private Limited versus ACIT. Recently decided case of ITIT Delhi. You may be surprised that how demonetization case went up to ITIT when 17 assessment year, 17-18 was over in December. No, that answer is very clear. That was a 153A read with 143.3 and broken period of search was covered. So there was a very high demand and sales of 93 or 73 crore rupees were added. So it was high pitched assessment and CIT appeal also decided against the SSC. But Delhi ITAT clearly stated, bear with me, addition made on basis of jump in sales without any verification was deleted. ITAT says, look, he has got stock, he has got cash memo. Then how you can add such thing in his assessment without any verification? So presumption, however strong, cannot become the basis. Now, second important case, Bombay High Court. 75 ITR, 33 Bombay. Whether it is necessary to give addresses of cash shares, many ITOs have written. Yet since the SSC is not having addresses of the cash customers, I am editing. I am adding it in the assessment. Whether this will sustain Bombay High Court system. No, even as of now, below 2 lakhs, there was no requirement on the demonetization day to provide PAN number of the cash shell customers under Rule 115 that time. So that ruling case is R.B. Jasiram Fatechand. Just because he could not provide addresses of cash shells customers, customer came to me. I gave him the goods, I collected cash, and there was a stock with me. I'm not supposed to give addresses of those customers who are purchasing cash from me. So Bombay High Court judgment, R.B. Jasaram Fatechand, will help you in such cases. Now, recently Madras High Court came to the rescue of the SSC. Now, there are two types of assessment, e-assessment, which were in 2017-18. We will not talk about faceless scrutinies, which are going on currently in 1819. Madras High Court also dealt with one demonetization cases. It has set aside AO's demonetization deposit addition made under 69A, mind you well. What was the logic? High Court says in the case of Salem Sri Ramila Chit Company that electronic assessment is appreciable, laudable, but it can lead to erroneous assessment. See, for example, I am giving you explanation orally that will make a lot of difference as compared to e-assessment. And AO did not call for further information when he was not satisfied with the demonetization deposited in cash by the SSC. And therefore, without any personal hearing or video conferencing or whatever, that was set aside by the AO. So this is very, very important judgment, Salem Sri Ram Vilas Chit Company, in which all these cases of e-assessment made without proper scrutiny or any inquiry conducted will be struck down based on this. Now, recent, Gordon versus DCIT. In this case, no addition can be made under Section 68. Just because there is a time gap of 5 months, as I told you, see, this is very important, time gap of 5 months between withdrawal and redeposit into bank. I always asking why you kept cash 5 months. Earlier, we also saw the case law where there was a savings kept in hand for 7 years also. In so many shell companies, you will find cash on hand line for several years. So those cases can definitely be fought with this type of cases, Gordon, that there was a cash on hand. And in which case, this was the case of Delhi IT. They have relied upon two case laws, Balrao's Raj Chandra, 121 TTJ 366 Delhi, and another of 163 Textbill 585, Kulwant Rai. cash flow statement, even if I have not maintained books of account, cash flow statement must be considered. And once I give cash flow statement, that cannot be rejected by the AO. Now, is cash deposited a sale? Answer is no. There are three judgments which says that I have already shown sales is my cash, credit side. Again, you are adding my cash deposited. So it amounts to double taxation of the sale income. So these three cases will help you a lot. Now, recent case of Indore Bank, Deva Soya Limited, 3636 Indore 2012, appeal number. The claim of the appellant that such addition resulted into double taxation of the same appears to be acceptable because on one hand, sale is already taxed, and on other hand, amount redeposited into the bank account by the SSC is added under section 68. My dear friend, this is the summary of assessment service search after demonetization. And there are certain other cases, Surana Traders of Mumbai Tribunal, in which while facing the bogus purchases, ITAT said, if there is no purchase, how sales could be effected? Now we are in the reverse mode. If I have sold the stocks, where is my stock line? So this will help, these two cases will help you. MP High Court, Gai Lama and Surana Traders. My dear friend, this was the summarized position of today's session. Now I request Mr. Rungta to pose the questions which I will try to answer to the best of my knowledge and ability, one by one. Yes, please.
So we have summarized the question over here. So you can see over the screen all the questions asked during the session.
Okay.
So one by one, you can take it. Okay.
Basic difference between section 115BB and section 68. Did I explain just now? Section 68 refers to unexplained cash credit alone, whereas 115BB is applicable to not only 68 but 69, 69A, 69B, 69C, 69D. So this is the basic difference. Now, Deepak ji ka ek sawal hai, sir, my question is why gold post was shifted from removing black money from system to being cashless economy. See, actually, cashless economy is the goal of the present government. They wish that nobody should deal in cash. You must be knowing that 40A3 was reduced from 20,000 to 10,000 thereafter. So that itself shows that after the post-immunization, they definitely want cashless economy. Today you can see, sitting at your home, you can transfer your payments, even though you are not allowed to go outside your home. That would have been, that is a vision of this government. And without that, it could not have been possible. Mr. Tekriwal ka sawal hai, what detail evidence by submitted AO shifting honors from other side? Cash buyer. I told you just now, Mr. Tekriwal, that in the cash of cash buyer, PAN number is not required if it is below 2 lakhs. Address is not required. I gave you Bombay High Court judgment. And address is also not required. Only requirement of cash buyer is that there should be official stock available with you.
Screenshot lete hain, chalo.
Then, Deepak ji ka dusra sawal hai. Yes, sir. When can we expect government to come up with full and final numbers regarding demonetization? This question is very ticklish. Demonetization full and final figures, I do not know. It is like a full and final figure of this coronavirus. It is anybody's guess. So I would refrain from giving answers because that is not within my purview and it is within the purview of RBI. Anyway, we should not bother much about that because we are dealing with taxes on demonetization other than that. In case of company has a cash and on one first case, all the withdrawn cash before the. This I have replied. Very well, you will succeed, Mr. Sharad Bhai Sheth. You will succeed. He's from Raipur. Yes, sir, you will succeed. I gave you case law also. not only 5 months, 7 years cash flows also I gave you. Okay, Mr. Mahadev Agarwal, please also give your views on 1 month by BP whether applicable. I told you the entire, this I have given you several times, that Vartika Township applies. So this is replied, Mr. Agarwal, your query is already replied in detail. Yes, Mr. Inani is very active. Huh? In many cases, AO has not initiated parallel EIS. Now he cannot. He has missed the bus. If penalty is not initiated in the return, sorry, in the assessment order, then he cannot invoke now. Yes. Next is Mr. Rati. He is from Indore. Yes. If books of accounts are rejected and tax levied on estimated income, whether AO can make additional section 68 and tax? See, now on this also, yes, this is a good question. He is a very good learner. He is always asking very difficult question to me wherever I am. Once the books are rejected and income is estimated, then section 68 cannot be made applicable at all because he is rejecting the books. Then where is the question of relying upon the same books? He cannot rely upon the same books at all. So I think that is answered in the favor of assessee. He can't rely upon that. Yes, any other question left thereafter?
Anyone who would like to ask a question can ask now.
Yes, there are quite a few other questions which was there.
Yes, please ask.
Sir, there is a question by Anand Maskara. Any income declared in the books on 115? In the books, can 115 be imposed?
Declared means what? Declared under what?
So declared under any heading, let's take for example, it has been declared under business.
No,
heading.
If there is no nature and source, then 115 BB would definitely will be involved. That is what I told.
Okay. But if it is shown under profit and loss?
Yes, sir.
Sir, if it is shown under profit and loss, will it still be, can it still, can 115 be imposed again?
Anandji, you will be unmuted. You can ask the question.
Without rejection of books, can he impose 115 BBE?
Yes, for 115 BBE, there is no question of rejection. Because he is adding under either 68 to 69D.
Sir, if I have got a sales and I have proved through my sale bills and I have recorded those in the books of accounts, as you have said that sales below 2 lakh doesn't require any proof.
Yes.
Then in that case, when I have shown in PL account, can he prove it to be a bogus sale?
Not at all. You will succeed. I gave you several case laws and then Delhi Tribunal, recent case law, 73 crore. They have deleted. Mr. Agarwal. They deleted 73 crore rupees addition. Yes, Mr. Inani says, cashiers whether mention cash instead of buyer name and addresses. Address is not required, I told you, no? Because that Bombay High Court judgment I gave you, no? Just now I gave you Bombay High Court judgment. Below 2 lakhs up to 8th November, there was no requirement of address, PAN number, etc. Only requirement was stock and availability of cash. That's all. Yes, any other question?
One more question, sir, I have.
Yes.
Whether, I think still one petition is pending in Supreme Court of India. I think Supreme Court of India is yet to dispose of. Why I am telling you, one of my relative, he is staying in London. Kept her cash in 500 or 1000 those demonetized money
okay. In
her locker. Now when she returned back, there was no time to deposit that because there was some restrictions also like some 20,000 or 50,000 what I remember.
Okay.
Now she still has got that actual money that is shown in her books lying in her locker.
Okay.
Now, what exactly, is there still anything pending or should I throw those money in Bay of Bengal?
I said Samudrikaran, no?
Yes, sir.
But that petition is mainly related to non-residents.
And, yes.
Normally, we are dealing with majority of the cases, as per my knowledge, are regarding residents. Am I right? Even if some exception comes or something, that may not affect the resident SSC. That is my understanding. Because you also talked about non-resident client. I think so.
Yes.
That's the thing. But anyway, you know, good observation. But now you know how the judiciary and everything is moving. And particularly in the era of this present crisis, I do not know what will be the future. Only God or GOK, God only knows. Anyway, any other question, please? We have about a few minutes more before we find out. No questions? And thank you very much. Let me summarize my session in 2 minutes. Mr. Rungta, can I summarize?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Please go.
Life itself is a demonetization. Leave your old ideas behind. Live with new ideas and new currency. That is the motto of life. Stay at home, stay safe, and I pray Almighty for not only of your wealth, but your health first. If there is no health, there is no wealth. Thank you very much for joining me on this webinar. See you sometime once again. Thank you very much, all of you.
Sir, vote of thanks is required. Mayur, please offer and the sir, vote of thanks.
And sir, one more request, sir. Quite a few of our attendees are requesting if you can share the PPT. So, sir, if
yes,
you can.
Yes, yes. In fact, in between, actually, I tried to upload the PPT and I got stuck up in that process. But then I tried to find out another way of working on it, because at any age, I am a learner. I am learning every day. I am techno savvy, and that's why I succeeded even with a gap of 1 or 2 minutes, no problem. And I completed before due date of your Zoom timing, because I know they are very strict. And this is a paid seminar, I know that. Anyway, that I'll be giving in a PDF, but don't make it like a public property and don't make it a coronavirus.
No, sir.
Because this will help you. Summarized version of all the case laws is ready with me. Yes. That I will be giving you. Because that all theories are useless for you. That is only for giving lectures. Unless you want to become a lecturer as a copycat of best lectures, then you can also do that. Okay.
On behalf of VIP Road Chartered Accountant Association, I'd like to thank the speaker of the day, Bhupender sir, and all the attendees who have joined us on this webinar. Thank you all for joining us. And we are also having 2 more webinars. We have shared the details of that on the groups and mails. So hope all of you join on our other webinars also. Stay safe, stay home. Thank you all.
Thank you. Thank you, Bhupender sir, for taking your valuable time out.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Bhupender sir, namaskar.
Namaskar. How are you?
Good, sir. Good. Sir, how are you? Sir, thanks. It was a very wonderful session. Yeah. It was actually very much a requirement, because all those assessments are going to be completed very soon. So we are definitely enlightened.
Yeah, definitely. Thank you, sir. Problem. And these case laws will help you to fight out specific point-wise assessments and appeals. I'll be sharing those definitely. Cases separately.
Sir, Bombay kya hala, sir? Bombay ka kya khabar hai sir? Aap log aaspaas sab?
My own area is very badly affected, and the fourth building from my house is sealed. I have not gone from my